Carl Faubert, private detective, had just traveled thousands of kilometers from Montreal to reach this remote, middle-of-nowhere area situated near the far northern Lake Atamipek. Granted, that was a great distance to cover for a sole client, but word had it that he was a particularly wealthy one. Carl had to drive a bit further north in order to meet with wealthy industrialist William Hamilton. William Hamilton was a prosperous owner who had acquired various businesses as well as metal mines in this northern region. Carl, always diligent in his work, always carried his log on him, in which he scribbled down thoughts and leads alike during the course of his investigations. The Polaroid, Carl's long-standing and faithful ally, had seen its share of husbands caught red-handed cheating. There's always something out there waiting to be snapped away, even when removed from civilization. Hamilton is waiting for Carl in the general store. It was time for him to get down to business. William Hamilton enjoyed a lavish country house built in the very heart of the northern forests, not too far from here. The local populace was divided when it came to the affluent man. Some saw a wealthy philanthropist dedicated to improving the region's economy. Others, an aging Englishman who would do anything to further his fortune. And these ones hated him enough to go on about scheming against him. Carl was not made aware that winter would come early this year. The North made clear who was the boss up there. Snow, which didn't care much about the date when it felt like dumping its first load of the year. Hamilton had recently acquired a few local businesses, but the last straw was the reopening of a mine, which gave rise to a wave of protests and threats from the Cree people. Whatever happened here, things got pretty rough. and not a trace of Hamilton. The general store also served as a post office. Letters and packages awaited the locals' daily visit. Carl was no electrician, but he could identify a wiring problem when he saw one. Carl proudly remembered an essential fact of his survival 101 class in the Army. Wolves won't approach crowded areas. Or was it about bears? The door was locked. Had to drive by every week to fill the bottles. The fresh milk indicated a recent visit. The snowstorm pummeled everything in its path. Carl was not surprised when he heard no tone. Amateur hunters showing some pride at having killed a nice pelted beast. With men like this roaming the area, wolves would become extinct within 10 years, Carl thought. The note explained that both the garage and the store shouldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time. Hate was in the air. Seems like some villagers barely tolerated each other. Strange phenomena. But a chunk of ice like this, as if an iceberg came out of the ground, that was a first. Shabby. Carl felt he needed to protect himself. It was a typical shack, just like the ones you hear about in Quebecois legends. Local lumberjacks used it to rest and twice a day heat up their pea soup. Cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. Mm-hmm. A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty. Were still warm. Someone must have been stirring them up. Window left open in that weather? Perhaps something had to be watched. And darkness came. Astonishingly enough, the electricity had managed to endure all this time. The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Cloutier and Sons. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts. Finding a key is easy. Finding the right keyhole, not so much.
Thank you. No.